What's going on, Knicks fans? I got a quick question for you. Let me know. Do you want the Knicks to start Emmanuel Quickly long term? I thought he played well Saturday night versus the Celtics. The team fell off in the second half and eventually got blown out. But I like what I saw from Emmanuel Quickly, especially in the first half. So if you want Emmanuel Quickly to be a starter for the Knicks long term, like this video. What's going on, everybody? I'm your host, Marshall Green, and you are watching New York Knicks Now. And we have a big show to get into, the latest trade rumors around Miles Turner, Jeremy Grant, and we're going to take a deep dive into Emmanuel Quickly, everything he's done this year, and we'll talk about if he should be a starter. But let's start with the report that Sham Charania had about the latest Knicks trade rumors, the first one around Jeremy Grant. He said this: several playoff teams are pursuing Pistons star forward Jeremy Grant. The Wizards, Knicks, Blazers, and Lakers, among others, sources said. Grant is sidelined due to a UCL injury in his right thumb, but Detroit will have a vast group of suitors for the 27-year-old. Grant, who is eligible for a four-year extension worth up to $112 million this offseason, is one of the most sought-after players this trade season. Grant, he's really becoming a really good player in the National Basketball Association. Last year, he was a finalist for one of the most improved players in the NBA, and he continues to get better every single year. Right now, his field goal percentage is a little bit down, hovering around 42%, but he is hitting the tray ball at a 33% clip, which is a little bit below average. But Jeremy Grant is not some sniper from deep, so I like that he's at least able to hit open jumpers, averaging over 20 points per game, about almost 5 rebounds per game. And the thing I like about him, he's an athletic wing that provides defensive help on the perimeter, and in the fast break in the open court, he's a finisher, and he can add some speed to this Knicks lineup. The thing that does concern me is the fact that he's due over $40 million for the next two seasons and that he is going to be looking for a max or a close to a max contract come the offseason following the 2022-2023 NBA season. He can't sign an extension following this year like Sham Charania said, but with the salary cap hit right now at about $20 million, who are the Knicks going to give up in a trade? Has it got to be a guy like Kemba Walker or somebody else? We'll talk about that in the first second. But something I like about Grant is he is an ascending player in the National Basketball Association. Last year, he was a finalist for the most improved player, and this year he has built off that, taking a step back in some statistical categories. He's been battling with a couple injuries, and right now he's not playing. But this is someone, a young player that still has a really high ceiling, and if he can cement himself as an above-average three-point shooter, this is a guy that could be a star in the National Basketball League Association, and this is a guy that would fit really well in the Knicks lineup, I think. But who are the Knicks going to give up? Are you willing to give up a guy like RJ Barrett or maybe multiple first round picks? Could you maybe trade Alec Burks, Kemba Walker, and a first round pick? Is that enough for Jeremy Grant? I'm not sure. I could see the Pistons easily maybe wanting Obi Toppin or Emmanuel Quickly, and I am not trading Quickly. I really like what I've seen as of late. I think you got to give up maybe one or two future assets along with the future first round pick or maybe two, but you be the GM. Take the seat of Leon Rose. Should the Knicks make a trade for Jeremy Grant? The Knicks, they need a superstar. I'm not sure if Grant is a superstar or ever can be. I think he's kind of a fringe star, similar to Julius Randle. I think Randle is a better player, but I do have concerns of who you would give up, and I'm not sure I'm ready to pay him a max salary. But get your votes in. Should the Knicks trade for Jeremy Grant? Type T for trade or type P for pass. If the Knicks make a trade, we'll be breaking it down on the channel right here, youtube.com/KnicksTV. We are your one-stop shop for all Knicks news and rumors throughout the NBA season. We react to breaking news. We present you with rumors that are floating around throughout the Twitter landscape for NBA, and we let you guys sound off on them. I give you my opinion, and I ask for yours. That's what we do here at Chat Sports. We are a really interactive YouTube channel. We're predicated off that. So if you love the Knicks, looking for a channel that does nothing but cover the Knicks? We're your channel. Hit that big red button. The next NBA trade rumor that Sham Charania talked about and I want to bring up is Miles Turner. I think he'd be a really good fit with them, and there are reports coming out that Shams has confirmed that the Knicks are interested, and that's been something that's been said all year long. This is what Sham said. Rival teams are ramping up conversations with the Pacers involving Caris LeVert and center Miles Turner. The Mavericks and the Knicks are expressing interest in trading for Turner, sources said. Turner is the NBA's leading shot blocker, averaging 2 0.9 blocks per game. That's one of my favorite things about Turner's game. Not only is he a stretch five that has the ability to score from all over the court, he is one of the best defensive centers in the NBA, and he has always, since he's been in the league, been a great shot blocker and rim protector. And outside of Mitchell Robinson and Nerlens Noel, who's been out, Taj Gibson's a good hard-nosed defender, but I wouldn't say he's a great rim protector. But Miles Turner is averaging over 13 points per game, almost 8 bounds, shooting 52% from the field and 35% from three. That's an area that he continues to get better every single season, and I think that would really add a different element to the Knicks game. I think Turner would be a really good fit in this offense, and I think it would take a lot of burden and pressure and scoring responsibility off of the guy's shoulders like Julius Randle. A lot of times, Randle's stuck at the four next to Mitchell Robinson or Nerlens Noel and Taj Gibson, and the paint is clogged. We all know Julius Randle is a downhill player, but if you pair him with Miles Turner and add that stretch five, the court widens up, the paint opens up, and it gives more room for Julius Randle to operate and another shooter that he can outlet pass to. I really think Turner and Randle would be a good fit, and I'd love to see a 4-5 pick and roll between the two players. I would really like for Miles Turner to be a Knick, but who knows what the Knicks would have to trade. But let me know what you think. Should the Knicks make a trade for Miles Turner? The NBA trade deadline is just 1 month away from today, so our trade coverage is going to be ramped up. I know a lot of you guys were asking, hey, Marshall, can we do more lineup stuff or talk about games? We'll do that in a second with Emmanuel quickly, but with the NBA trade deadline around the corner, we got to talk about the latest trade rumors. So let me know. Should the Knicks make a trade for Miles Turner? Type 1 for yes or type 2 for no. Something that I think every Knicks fan is talking about, and after you watch the Knicks play against the Boston Celtics on Saturday this past weekend, you gotta wonder, should the Knicks start Emmanuel quickly long term? I really liked what I saw from him in the first half, and Tibbs, he really sung the praise of quickly following the game when Evan Fournier had to be held out of the lineup due to that thigh contusion. This is what Tibbs had to say about Quick. I thought he played really well. The first half, he had us organized and had real good looks. It was a good start for him. And I want him to take more control in the second half, and I think he will. He's done a really good job for us. I really like what I saw from Tom Thibodeau what I saw from Emmanuel quickly, and that's what Tom Thibodeau echoed. 18 points, 4 assists. He was 7-11 from the field and 3-5 from the three-point line. One thing that's been holding Emmanuel quickly back from being a star in this league and a rising star, I think he is already a rising player in the NBA, and he could be a fringe all-star one day, a six-man candidate, but I want him to be a starter because what I saw in this game is he was another scorer that the Knicks could look to. RJ Barrett didn't have to carry the scoring load. Neither did Julius Randle. Emmanuel quickly came out in that first half and was firing. He was hitting three-pointers. He was hitting shots from all over the field, and I really like what I've seen from him. This is a guy that pushes the tempo, and he's learning how to be a real point guard. Get the ball to other players and scoring opportunities, and that's something that we have seen that he didn't do last year. Last year, he was just asked to put the biscuit in the basket. This year, he's asked to control the offense. That's what Tibbs talked about, and we've seen that more and more. The last 8 games, quickly has been on fire and playing some of the best basketball of his young NBA career, averaging over 14 points per game, just shy of 3 assists. I would like to see that go up more, and I think that a number will go up more with the more starts he gets with the Knicks. He's shooting at 42.8% from the field, which is a little low. I'd like to see him hover around that 45% range, but when you're shooting the ball from deep at a 43% clip, you really can't complain. Quickly is instant offense off the bench. I think he has Lou Williams potential, but like I said, I want to see what he can do in a starting lineup next to RJ Barrett and Julius Randle. I want to give a shout out to my guy Tommy Beer, one of the best Knicks follows on Twitter. If you're not already following, hit him up. He's always putting out awesome stats. He had a cool write-up on Emmanuel quickly. He said this: Quickly is the only NBA player to ever tally at least 150 made trades and 200 assists while committing fewer than 100 turnovers over his first 100 games. The Knicks are allowing just 103.6 points per 100 possessions with Quickly on the court. That number jumps all the way up to nearly 113 points per 100 possessions with IQ on the bench. IQ's cumulative, I can't even read, I'm sorry, fellas, plus minus this season is plus 41. By far the best on the team. No other Knick has a plus-minus above 95. He leads the Knicks in total points scored in the fourth quarter this season at 166. Is shooting a scorching 44.2% from downtown and 92% from the free throw line in the final frame. There are only two players in the league who have more total points and more made three-pointers in the fourth quarter of games this season than Quickly. Sacramento's Buddy Hield, and you guessed it, Steph Curry. I'm not saying Emmanuel Quickly can be Steph Curry, but I do think he could be a guy that the Knicks rely on late in games to get buckets. This is an instant offense type of guy. He has the microwave badge on 2K for sure. This is someone that just rolls the ball out, and he's just a hooper, dude. He's a walking bucket. I like what I've seen from Quickly, and the growth is really inspiring, and maybe he can be the point guard of the future for the New York Knicks. But sound off. Should Quickly be a starter for the Knicks? Type S for starter or type 6 for six man. And guys, if you're still watching this late in the video, that means we're doing something right. So go down and hit that big red button. We're trying to get to 5,000 subscribers here on the channel. And that's only possible if people like you that continue to watch these videos day in and day out hit that big red button. I want to thank everybody that already does. And if you haven't, do it now so we can keep making more videos. More subs equals more videos here at Chat Sports. And if you're looking for another Knicks talking head on Twitter, follow me. I'm your guy. Born a Knicks fan, bleed blue and orange. I'm always tweeting and talking about the Knicks. I love talking Knicks basketball with Knicks fans. So let's do it over on Twitter. Hit me up at Marshall Green _.